Hello, Dr. Urban here. I'm continuing my series of considerations for as you want to reverse cognitive decline. And this is number five in my series on how to reverse cognitive decline. And it has to do with an old friend of mine, vitamin D. Last week I just ran into some information about vitamin D that really excited me. It still does, because my old friend is even better than I thought. So what's the deal with vitamin D and cognitive decline? Now, we're not talking about things like, well, we will a little bit about gut health, but there's so many things. So let me go to an authority who I think is better established at this than I am, than me. Dr. Stephen Gundry, in his book, The Plant Paradox, and that is the diet I think you should be on because it deals with lectins. And if you don't cover lectins in your diet, you're falling short, in my opinion. But anyway, he says, I cannot emphasize enough that the vast, this is on page 223, majority of people are profoundly vitamin D deficient. In my opinion, vitamin D is the single most important missing ingredient necessary to restore your gut health and therefore your overall health. I think that summarizes what he says. He says more about vitamin D. Let's go to another author. This is Dr. Dale Bredesen in his book, The End of Alzheimer's. It's a great book. It's a tougher read, in my opinion, than The Plant Paradox. But he says that reduced vitamin D activity is associated with cognitive decline. Vitamin D travels through your blood and tissues like a Wi-Fi signal entering your cells. Once inside, it binds to a receptor, enters the nucleus, and turns on over 900 genes. Okay, so just imagine so that upregulating or turning on is good for you in vitamin D. Yeah, it is. So consider vitamin D when you have brain fog, cognitive decline. Can't do things, little memory issues, all that stuff. Really, you should consider it if you're in good health. I've taken it for years to avoid cold and flu. And I have a video in the link below, a link in the video in the description below, so you can go there. So how much vitamin D do I take? I take 10,000 units a day as a maintenance dose. Now here's my multivitamin. I take multivitamin for trace elements like molybdenin and other things, trace elements, because they may show up as being really important later on, and I've got them on board for years. But I supplement with vitamin D, and I take the, let me just show you my visual aid here. Okay, I've got this little it's a little gelatin or whatever capsule, and that's 5,000 international units of vitamin D. I take two of those every day as a maintenance a dose, and that's a consideration. I can't tell you that I'm treating anything, or the FDA and powers to be don't like me to do that. So don't make any changes to your healthcare regimen without first consulting your healthcare providers, and that only makes sense. But on the other hand, if you hear the supplements don't work, well, you need to catch up. If or they need to catch up. If you believe that diet alone is going to take care of this, I probably can't help you with any. But anyway, if you'd like to continue, oh, I do want to correct one thing. Vitamin D is the single most important ingredient for gut health, but it may not be the single most important ingredient to get out of cognitive decline issues. Why? Because you may have something like heavy metal poisoning, to say, as an example, mercury. Or you may be profoundly low in vitamin D12, B12. Well, you need to take those missing ingredients, and that will be more important than just vitamin D. But when you're starting out, make sure your vitamin D, you consider make vitamin D as an important cog. So I've made it number five in my series. And because you may not go through all my videos or at any one time, so I want to catch your attention early. So consider vitamin D3. It has to be vitamin D3. Don't take anything else. So be well, subscribe to my channel, and let's keep going with, let's fight back and endeavor strongly to reverse cognitive decline.